What is up, guys? Scylla here, welcome back to another episode of The Legend of Zelda Twilight Princess HD. In the last episode, we gave freaking Agatha a crap ton of bucks. And this one, we're gonna go, we're gonna do a bit more collecting. We're actually gonna do a fair bit of collecting. So, what is in this rock? Oh. Hey, money! It looked like a lot more than it was. It was like 30 rupees. I was like, that's like easy 50 rupees. I guess it was like 40 rupees, but whatever. Anyway, we're gonna be making our way all the way to, okay, I just realized. I didn't freaking grab horse grass. I need a Pona. And it will make me go so much faster. I forgot to grab a Pona. Now I have to go all the way back over here where the horse grass is. It's freaking right there, you see it? All the way over there. By this dude. I'm gonna have to deal with him. What? Well. I was like, can I even hit him? Oh, there's a Pona. Well. You know what, we're gonna redundantly use this thing. And hey, Pona, even though you... Pona teleported, apparently. She was over here, but she came from the other direction. Pona actually has magical powers, if you guys didn't know. But anyway. I'm going to... You know, screw that rock, I'm not going back for it. But in this episode, we're gonna be going to Zora's domain and doing some stuff around that area. Actually, a lot of stuff around that area. So let's start doing that. We're gonna be getting like a crap ton of stuff, and it's a lot of useful stuff as well. It's not like bugs. We are getting some bugs, but we're getting more useful stuff than bugs. Hop off here. Ouch. See ya, Pona. Have fun with the Tektite. But, now we got that deal with, we're already in Zora's domain. Woohoo! Yeah, it looks cool in the night. I'm gonna go up here. On the steep path. Bop! Get some. Okay, guess I have to go bop again. Get some more money. And now we're at the very top. And I'm gonna destroy these boxes to see if I can get arrows or bombs. I don't even think I can get bombs. I like, no, for a fact I can't get bombs from grass because that doesn't even make sense. But. Trying to find arrows, but guess not. Rip. Anyway, now let's go to Zora's domain, shall we? And in Zora's domain, well, we're gonna... Wait a sec. Have we done this already? I forget if we have. If you light these torches... I'm pretty sure we've done this, right? We've done this. Guess we haven't done this. Well, there's a chest. Anyway, now we gotta put on our Zora suit. For a couple reasons. Maybe the iron boots? Yeah, we still got the iron boots. Alright. So now that we have the Zora suit, we can actually breathe underwater and go all the way under here. What we got? We got 50 rupees. That's not that big of a deal. Alright, let's equip our water bombas. And we can actually Z-target this thing, if you saw. But, if we throw this bomb at it... There's actually a Goron that pops out and he's like, hey dude. Hey buddy. I'm finally out. Thanks, brother. I took a nap and found myself swallowed up in lava and somehow very far from home. Ah, yes. Well, let me give you a token of my appreciation, brother. This is all I have on me right now. I hope it will do. And we got back with bombs. So now, I don't have to use my freaking bomb. I don't have to use my, whatchamanugs as, bomb arrows, water bombs. I might actually need more water bombs. And if I do, I'll just go buy more off screen. But I don't know if I will yet. I think that's all we needed for water bombs. It says swim through here. Get taken away by the current. We can swim under the mesh. Then we get pooped out, we're like, woo! No, I don't want to. I guess he'll take us all the way up. I didn't even know that was there. Anyway, if we go over here, we can actually get a new... I just nearly said fish. I meant bug. Hello, dragonfly. No, dragonfly? I don't like your sass. Come to me, my friend. Yoink! I get a male dragonfly. Now, let's go over to the other side where we can get the female dragonfly. Actually, no, we don't get the female dragonfly on the other side. We get it. Nope. Go away. Please. Alright. Arrows. No. Okay. Depressed. Anyway, let's continue down here. This is gonna be a long one, boys. We're in it for the long haul this episode. Because this is like, we have a crap ton of stuff to do. Let's snipe that one right there. Whoop. Grab some, rupees. We're getting tons of rupees in this episode. Also, it's like the morning. It's like the morning brightness. And let's grab this bug here. It's actually the female dragonfly. Bug fans love that golden collar. Anyway, talk to her. A customer? Sorry, but we're temporarily closed. Oh, that sucks. Wait, what the heck? No. No, not as normal Link. It's actually easier as normal Link, I think. But whatever. I like fighting things in as normal Link better. Yeah! Okay, let's deal with this one, and then we can deal with these. Now come closer. And done. Easy as pie. Obviously, you need two spin attacks. That would be easy if you only needed one. She's like, her afro's shaking. Well, that's Scrammy, who are you? I can keep your cool fighting monsters like that. Oh, wow, you. Wow, what a champ you are. Well, what are we standing around drawing for? Come on inside. Did I read that right? Did it say jawing? Golly, talk about scary. I thought it was done for. Things have been getting pretty crazy around here, let me tell you. So thanks for earlier. My name's Isa. I rent boats here. Well, I used to rent boats here. But then we had a rock fell and it dammed the rumor up. Yeah, I could sure use a helpful guy around at times like this. Yep, a handy guy would sure be a big help around here. I'll help. You're a lifesaver. Well, do you think you could do something about that rock? Well, I'll give you some bombs and arrows so you put them together and shoot bomb arrows at the thing. Oh. Dude, you ready? Ready for the sick meme? Damn it. Ha! Get it? Because it's like a damn ha! Sorry. It's a pretty trash pun, not gonna lie. Yeah, you did it. Well, my gal tells me there's still some rocks blocking the way along. River, so you could take care of that. Here's the boat, hop in. Now, it's a teensy bit dangerous downriver of here, so don't leave the boat, okay? One of our part-timers is just waiting down here so you can get the details from her. When you're done, you can keep that bomb bag and everything in it as a token of my appreciation. So, be seeing ya. So now we got infinite bombs and arrows, and that's really helpful, and it's nice. You know what I should have done? I should have, like, put my, maybe if I put my water bombs on my arrows, she would have filled up my water bombs. Maybe that would have been a good idea. But I don't know if that's how it works. Anyway, just go on here. It's pretty easy. It's just like a leisurely ride. Also, that arrow went underwater. I'm pretty sure if you, like, don't actually move the control stick, you can just, like, the water just takes you along. But you go slowly, so. If you paddle, you can, like, cut corners. Because we'll be, So, this is a fun thing you can do. If you actually go this way, you can actually glitch the game because it's like, no, don't go this way. Ow. You're like, phew! See, it doesn't work? It's because the assistant that the lady was talking about is actually over there. So it actually warps us. Ah, you've come at the request of the shop owner, haven't you? Why am I playing? You see these rocks are blocking the natural flow of the river. All you need to do is use your bomb arrows to destroy the blockage. And Link, like, warps over here because they're like, you know what, I don't want you to go to the death. Just mess with the game a little bit. Yeah, thank you. And the water has already begun to float. Then I shall guide you to the mouth of the river. Follow me. It's not really a glitch. It's more of like we're going backwards, boys. We're going backwards. Don't hit the rock. Ooh, I juked the rock. Yeah, she/he drop rupees along the way. I don't even know what gender. I'm pretty sure Zoras have genders. Like, 99% sure Zoras have genders. But they might not be genders like humans. I'm not gonna get into the whole gender thing. I'm gonna get triggered people. But I'm gonna be like #76genders. I'm like more like #soldier76genders, lol. I don't know where I'm going with this. But I'm just saying Zoras, maybe they're genders, dude. Zoras can identify however they want to. Let's see if I can shoot the Zora. Can I shoot you? Nope, guess not. Now, we're back at Lake Hylia. Yay! Now that we've cleared up all the blockage. I like how that happens. It looks funny. Hello? Oh, good job out there. You've truly done us a great service. Now the shop can finally reopen. When we were closed, my boss's temper only got worse and worse. This is a rough time for all of us. Oh, and one other thing. I don't suppose she promised you anything special for doing this, did she? Just that bomb bag, right? Yeah, she tends to bribe people with whatever's lying around. So stingy, really. It's alright. I'll let her know you kept it when I get back. Oh, thanks. Got a bag with bombs. That's our third bomb bag. Now, if you'll excuse me, come visit at the shop anytime. Okay, I will. Now, with that, I'm actually going to put on my normal clothes. Because I don't know if it's true or not, but it feels like you swim faster with normal clothes on. I know it's like weird because you have like flippers and everything. You're like, oh, you'll swim like way faster with shoes on. Or not shoes, Zora suit on. It's not like Link's wearing his Tim's. But, yeah, I don't know. I always felt that it felt faster, swimming with the hero's tunic. But anyway, let's continue on. And we're gonna go, up to, Hyrule Field again through the cannon. Because we got some stuff to do. Because we need to go all the way back to Zora's domain. I don't know if there's a quick way to do it. I'm sure there's a quick way to do it, but we're going this way. Hey, buddy. Hey, you're back. It's a ride. Give it a shot. Let's go. And we'll pop a sick lunch. He looks so happy. No, he doesn't look happy. Okay. Anyway, aim the cannon and fire. And there we go. And now that we're back up here, we can go all the way back to Zora's domain. Okay, now we're gonna do everybody's favorite minigame. I'll show you in a sec when I get to the horse grass. Actually, it's gonna be a little bit before we get there. But, yeah. Anyway, I'm gonna take the time to talk about another topic. How about we talk about the Switch? Who's freaking pumped for Breath of the Wild? I know I am. And, like, I don't know. I'm not the biggest fan of open world games. Like, I was, like, never like, oh my god, Skyrim's so good. I didn't really like Skyrim that much. I don't know. I kind of like, I know it's gonna sound weird, but I kind of like linear games. Because it's, like, a bit easier to finish, you know? Because I struggle with finishing games. Not because I, like, get stuck or anything, it's just because I'm like, oh, don't really want to figure it out. Except, you know, if it's a really good game, I will. Like, I finish every Zelda game I play. Except I didn't finish, Triforce. What's it called? Triforce Hero? Alright, there's the dog barking again. Hopefully you guys can't hear that. Anyway, yeah, I didn't finish the three-player Zelda game. Please, dog, be quiet. There's a new neighbor moved in next to me, and they have a Dalmatian. Pretty cute, but it barks a lot. Alright, back at Zora's domain. Okay, what? I tried to roll there, but not. Dog plus. And now we're gonna go and do some side quests. Gonna pop a sick dive. Not really a dive, because we had our sword out. But, alright, the doggo calmed down, I think. Also, rip Gabe the dog. Yeah, if you don't know who Gabe the dog is, he was like a... he's a meme. Now, his existence was a meme, but... you know, those Bork things. Yeah, he's my favorite meme! And he freaking... dies. Poor dude. Anyway. Off sad topics. We're gonna go... and not do that yet. We're gonna go and do none other than some fishing, boys. This is actually a really cool area. It is the fishing hole. And it's really chill and it's really nice. Oh, and there's like cherry blossoms on the trees. This area actually changes with the seasons, which is really cool. But, in order to fish, we obviously need our fishing rod, so let's equip it. And the music's really nice in here, let's read this. Don't litter, do not toss empty bottles or cans here, the fish are crying. Aw, look, there's even ducks! Aww. Anyway. Clearly, since the sign was there, about no fishing. I forget how to fish. Do I just hit up? I forget. Do I hit back? Do I hit A? Well, I probably hit Y. Yeah, there you go. I figured out how to fish. Ooh, look, we got a green gill. 9 inches. Grab this heart. I'd make a Brian joke here and be like, lol, 9 inches, not even as big as me, but I'm not gonna pop a Brian joke. Brian can reserve those jokes for himself. Anyway, fish on. also, oh my god, we got an empty bottle. We got a freaking empty bottle from fishing. That's pretty freaking sweet. Anyway, I was talking, I've actually decided on the next Let's Play I'm gonna do, and I'm pretty freaking I'm humped for it, guys, I'm totally humped. I meant to say I'm pumped for it, but, yeah, I'm pretty freaking pumped for the Let's Play, because it is a game I actually haven't played, and I have played other games in the series. And he's like, whoa, what the heck? Oh my god. Hey there. Hey you. Have you never been here before? Well, I'm the owner of this fishing hole. My name's Hina. Nice to meet you. Hello, Hina. 20 rupees to try some lure fishing. There's no time. The canoe's rental included. Want to give it a shot? Not yet. I'm gonna look around your shop. Go ahead. Yeah. Yeah. So, you can actually look at stuff. That's mine. You know, it's generally considered polite to take your hat off when you come indoors. Yeah, sorry. That's my older sister. That shot is from the day she caught herself is a 17-inch bass. Her name's Isa, by the way. Make sure to drop by her boat. Yeah, we already helped her. Anyway, that's a 22-inch high roll bass I caught. It's not very big, but it's a fish I spotted and caught all by myself, so I took that picture. I mean, it's not that small. That's me and the first fish I caught here, a 28-inch Hylian pike. I swear I'll never forget that day. Such sweet memories. And there's a... Oh my god, it's Koro. That's my older brother, Koro. And a 25-inch Oregon catfish he caught. He's the only one in our family who's lousy at fishing. He only managed to catch that fish by using a sinking lure. Cheater. We have a sinking lure. And, here's a little throwback. That's one of Hyrule's legendary master fishermen. Look, he's got a Hylian loach, doesn't he? You can tell he's from a other game because he's so polygon. He just may be one of my ancestors. Of course, I can't exactly prove that. It's just kind of just wishful thinking on my part. Anyway, if you couldn't tell, he's from Ocarina of Time. And I thought I could look at this. Yeah, I can. That's a special fish tank for just my customers. I'm fond of those green gills, of course. But if you catch anything, I'll toss it in too. Of course, I don't want to encourage that. Anyway, can we look at the bird? Can't look at the bird. Bird. There you go. So cute, isn't she? Her name's Purdy. She even talks sometimes. And she ain't the only thing that's Purdy. I'm just kidding. You want to try some lure fishing? It's 20 rupees for the whole deal. There's no time limit. And the canoe's rentals included. Yeah, I already read this. I don't know why I'm saying it again. Seeing how this is your first time and all, I'll throw in the guide service for free. Let's get fishing. Yeah, and now we get to fish with our little lady friend. She put on her hat. Also, we're not actually really fishing for fish. We're more fishing for this beautiful thing. Choo-choo! And we hooked it, and look at what we got, boys. What's that? A piece of heart? Oh, whose did you catch, you big sweetheart? Don't be shy, this one's yours to keep. Oh, thanks. Maybe it cut her heart. Lol. Link's getting in with, like, every lady he's ever talked to. This is, like, way harder to do than the freaking, other one. Oh, wait, I forgot. I have to hit help to quit. God quits. Really want to quit? Yes, I do want to quit. Thanks. I mean, I caught my piece of heart and all. Oh, all done? Too bad this time. Oh, well. Well, better luck next time. I mean, I got a freaking piece of heart. That's pretty good with me. There's, like, another mini-game you can do in here. And it's, like, one of those ball mini-games. But I'm not going to do that because it doesn't give you anything. I think it gives you rupees, maybe. But I don't know. Anyway, this area looks really nice, and I like the music here. But now that we're done with the fishing hole, I don't know. I might come back here and try and catch some fish. I know I'm not going to catch all the fish because there's not really a point in doing that. But, let's come here. Let me just equip my bombs and arrows. Here, I'm going to try what I thought about earlier. I'm going to see if she fills up my bomb arrows, or my water bombs, if I equip them to my bomb arrows. Let's see. Hopefully she does. Hey, welcome. Thanks to you, we're back in business. Well, we can't offer much, but just make yourself at home. And of course, if you want a boat ride, just let me know. I'd be happy to rent you one. Yes, please. I want a boat ride. Rent me one. Okay, hop in. You all set? Have a good race. Okay, now with this, what we gotta do is we actually have to shoot these pots. If we hit the walls, we lose points. So let's not hit the walls. Alright, there's the first pot. And chablam. But yeah, like I said, if you're struggling with this, it's actually pretty easy. You just have to like let the water take you instead of going against the water. Because the water, as long as you're aiming, I think, then the water takes you along the path automatically. Like, see, it's just like, see, it moves the boat automatically. Which is actually really nice. Ow. Chablam. And we're about to hit a wall, so we're gonna turn. We're gonna shoot that. I've done this flawless multiple times, so hopefully I can do it on my first try. Not flawless, but in order to get our prize, we need to get 25. So let's actually go left here. Chabam! 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 Please, excuse me. Did we get that one? Yeah, we did. Okay. Okay, make sure to get the red one, because those count for two. I'm gonna hit the rock. We're fine. It's fine, guys. It's fine. Let's blow this one up. It'd be sweet if we got a flawless run. Seriously, doubt we're going to. Watch out for this rock in the middle here. And try and go this way, because that's where all the point ones are. If you go the other side, you don't get any points. Like, you can still shoot them from the other side, but there's none on that side, is what I'm saying. Come on. Left. Obviously, we're not flawless because we hit the rock, but whatever. I mean, let's try and not miss one. So far, we just need four more, which is pretty easy to get because there's like a rush of them at the end. Ow. Ow. As you just saw there, if you, hit the wall, it like sets off a chain reaction, like you keep hitting the wall, but hopefully, boom, 27. We did it, boys. Let's just not hit the wall twice now. And we did it. Good job, squad. First try. I feel like we only got hit three times, so I think the maximum we can get is 30, and I know we didn't miss any, so I think 30 is the max, and that's what I thought it was earlier as well, so. Anyway, now that we're back at Lake Hylia. Thanks for your patronage. Oh, this trip down river, you scored 27 points destroying targets. Congratulations at the first customer to score at least 25 points. You received this prize. And we get a freaking giant bomb bag, which looks really cool. It looks like a face. It can hold 20. The exact number they can hold depends on the kind of bomb. Come again anytime. So I think if it's normal bombs, it holds 60. If it's water bombs, it holds 30. And then there's another type of bomb that we can't get yet. And my theory was wrong. Did they just like upgrade one of my bomb bags or no? Yeah, they just upgraded one of them. So they upgraded the bottom one. As you can see, if I take this off, it's not full. So yeah, that one probably holds 60. Anyway, I think that's going to be the end of this episode. So in the next one, we might be doing a small bit more of collecting. I don't think we'll do much, but we might do a little bit. And then we're going to be getting onto the temple, probably in the next one after that. So hope you guys enjoyed. There's the dog barking again. And, hope you guys enjoyed. If you did, make sure to drop a like and subscribe. And I guess I'll see you guys next time. Bye.